no opportunity to mule. Tassadar having the opportunity to pick up that mule and heal it up there as best as possible. But then look at that isolation, trying to get on these camps. Zuna and Kenma both zoning out here. That's what I was talking about. Zuna just wants to pick up all the coins. He knows if he gets the coins, he dictates the pace of the map.
All right, Fan having to teleport to safety. The heals were there from Kenma. Nicely done. But Graeme starting to chunk out that damage. Kenma getting very low. The Ancient Spear from Zuna trying to back away, but Kenma does end up falling. The first death of the game. Now Zuna very low. Four gems will be dropped there, but the pull-in with the towers in range and the big orb goes out and takes out Brightwing. Pick onto that Li Ming. King of Bleeds Devil can definitely bring it back.
This is crucial. So not only does this fight, obviously it's very important because both teams are on even footing. Whatever team wins gets 15 coins, which is a turn-in for both sides. So they essentially give up a turn-in no matter what, but look how split they are right now.
Uh-oh.
Koba is completely separated from each other. Ooh. In the 4 versus 5. Great mod here, Jake. This is going to be a risky team fight.
Yeah, Collusion is getting burned down. They swap the Disintegrate over to the single target, but the flank there from Frozen X on Lunar doing a lot of damage. They're turning it around. We do see the nice Divine Shield used to keep Zuna standing. The Poly going out, and that is going to be a dead early in this fight. Tomster in the back trying to go back in with that Wolf Form. Gets the kill. They're turning around. King of Blades might have this, but Fan trying to snowball with Li Ming, doing so much damage from afar, and there goes Lunar. Reventic really doing a great job collecting as many coins as possible, initiating with the Shrink Ray there on Greymane, but the follow-up, the peel is successful. Poly used very early in this
battle. But the turn-in, they're going to back away from the situation. Oh no, they didn't complete the entire turn in there, so this is going to be a risky fight.
Whoa.
Here.
Urho needs the Divine Shield to stay alive, but a massive Maw. They're getting in position. The Condemn used a little bit early, a mistake, but it doesn't even matter. Shredding through the health bars, the reset there on Li Ming, getting another kill, once again resetting, and that will be a turn in. This is a game point situation for Niventic.
If they lose too many, it's going to be game. It's not even going to be a turn in. Yeah, you're going to rotate to mid, they're going to end the game right now. Niventic is going to walk away here with game number one on Blackheart's Bay of all maps here, Jake.
Not a common first map, and what a decisive end to that with that Maw. Well played by Niventic.
And they're just kind of dancing it out a little bit here. The wave clear isn't going to be that dominant for either of the teams quite yet. ETC getting caught out a little bit there, and it might be... it's not going to happen too much. The great Raw stun there on McIntyre. That's
going
to cost him his life. That is one dead wolf. Really well done. The Raw stun from Trees and Urho now as well.
The wolf, the feral lunge, and a quick two for nothing there for King of Blades Alpha. A great start.
Goes on the bottom half of the map. It might be a struggle for them. Kenma looking to engage, but he might be too far. Ooh. Stun coming out.
Big power slide by Kenma backing away, dodging the Lunar Flare. King of Blade Trees is actually very low, but able to retreat in this situation. The double support working out nicely, but Collusion is going to go down.
It's one of those situations where the struggling Zuna instantly on mid. Really well done on his part. Nothing to try and come back in this game. And here we see Collusion going to be picked out a little bit here. And the bottom shrine already won by Niventis.
Ooh, huge damage. The Ancestral Hill cannot connect. McIntyre and Fan with a huge damage. Collusion going into the water. That is a cow drinking from the well. And Jaina will join him.
It's very crucial. And then you're like, well, that's not that important because they'll die to core. But guess what? That's the lane where there is going to be the shrine. And that lane with the shrine, oh man, look at him trying to make something happen here. Niventic actually looking to get a little bit too hypey possibly, but over
man.
The wall. Fan unleashing that Disintegrate. There,
okay,
Jake.
The gust goes out. Urho is still in, and that puts him in a bit of a dicey situation, but the self-sustain is there. Lunar Flare and Hunter's Mark pick up the kill, but the huge damage from Fan over the wall. Ancestral Heal gonna top off one, but Trees cannot stay alive. No, barely sustaining through, but the Ancient Spear of Zuna takes out Rhaegar with trading ETC on the left side. 3-for-1 for Niventic.
That was a really good job on Fan's part getting the blink to try and ensure that. That is almost likely, yeah, most likely going to be one dead Jaina here. Uther's mounted up. That is going to be it. She's going to fall apart here. And that's going to be four people dead. They might be looking to go to core.
Oh,
he went to get the cap, and the G-Shield came out. That was actually to ensure the fact that he gets the cap. Miscommunication on Niventic.
All right, here a lot of damage going there onto Urho. They actually got back, but Tyrannic is picked in the back, and the reset there. Fan is just going to town, shredding through their health. McIntyre diving in. The Dragonite will be picked up in the back of this, and Ancestral here, too little, too late. Frozen X and Jaina, the only two still alive. I don't think they can defend this.
They definitely can at this point. That's going to be four people dead for 30 seconds minimum.